Hello everyone, my name is Iris Franz, and today we're going to talk about income elasticity. So by definition, income elasticity is equal to percentage change in quantity demanded divided by percentage change in income. So if your income goes up by 10% and your quantity demanded for a certain good increased by 50%, then your income elasticity will be equal to 50% divided by 10%, that gives you 5. And notice that you no longer take the absolute value of income elasticity because the sign of income elasticity actually has a meaning. So if your income elasticity is less than 0, is a negative number, then the good is an inferior good. Because your income goes up, then your quantity demanded goes down. So think about bus rides. If you prefer to drive, then bus rides. Then after your income goes up, you no longer take bus rides. And therefore, your quantity demanded for bus rides goes down when your income goes up. So bus rides to you will be an inferior good. If your income elasticity is between 0 and 1, then that's a normal good. And in particular, it's a necessity. So suppose your income doubles, and you like pasta, are you going to consume twice as much pasta as before? No, that's just absurd. You probably are going to eat a little more pasta, but not twice as much. So suppose you eat 5% more pasta after you get a 100% raise, then your income elasticity for pasta will be just 0.5. You can see it's greater than 0, but it's less than 1. That tells you the good is a necessity. And if your income elasticity is greater than 1, then the good is a luxury. So, for example, if you get a 10% raise and you take Caribbean cruises 50% more, then Caribbean cruises income elasticity is equal to 5. And that tells you it's a luxury. So what's the point of learning income elasticity? Well, if you, in the future, you're in a business, in different industries, you are going to care about income elasticity. So when there is a recession, if you're selling luxury, you're going to suffer the most because of this big income elasticity. When people's income are going down, then they're going to consume a lot less of your good. So think about Caribbean cruises. If you are in the cruise industry and there's a recession, you know you're going to suffer big time because people are going to cut their consumption of luxury, the first and the most. And if you're selling necessity, then you probably don't worry that much during a recession. Because think about pasta. During a recession, you're cutting your spending on many things. But how much pasta can you cut? I mean, you still need to eat to survive. And therefore, if you're selling necessity during the recession, then you worry, but not as much as if you're selling a luxury. What if you're selling an inferior good? Then you're going to benefit from a recession. So think about McDonald's during year 2008 and 2009. McDonald's was actually expanding. Why? Because people consume more of inferior good when their income went down. And I hope this mini video helps. And next time you calculate income elasticity, you know why you're calculating them. Because in the future, you're going to care.